Howdy, folks. It's your favorite outsider artist, Manacle Mark, coming to you from the bunker system located underneath the Yard Villa found somewhere in the jungles of the Midwest. Today, I'm coming to you with a Manic Mark magical musical moment. That's right. Usually when I say that, I put the reverb on top of it and stand up with this thing.
Manic Mark magical musical moment.
That's right. Isn't that irritating? I think it is. Okay. So the magical Manacle Mark musical irritating moment today is brought to you by Mrs. Miller. And Mrs. Miller, as some of you may know, or you'll know it when you hear it, she's a well-known oddball artist. And her first name is Elva. And she was discovered by Gary Owen in 1960. Gary Owen, as you may remember, was the announcer on the Laugh-In show, and he found her somehow. I don't know how. And she would have been, she's 50 years old when she was discovered. But it was another 5 years before she found her way into the studios at Capitol Records. Yes, indeed, Capitol Records, and she made an LP, her first LP. Here it is. I'll put it up on the screen. There's a photograph of the LP. That's her first LP, and it was called Mrs. Miller's Greatest Hits. Well, being the first one, Greatest Hits what? Well, I think that was just kind of tongue-in-cheek. she had vocal training in school, and she loved opera, but she couldn't keep time and slid in and out of tune, which they found very useful to sing covers of popular songs to kind of make an oddball artist out of her, okay? But what is cute about her is that she's spent her whole life trying to be serious, and she had this opportunity, and she understood what they were doing, and she went along with it. She liked playing to the audiences, although she's quoted as her career being mismanaged and misinterpreted. And she was also quoted as not being sorry when it ended a short time later on. Because you spend 30 years working on something that you think's sort of serious, and then you're just held up as being kind of a kook, lovable, as the case may be. It's going to be hard to give up that 30 years of brain conditioning, whatever it is that keeps artists doing this stuff with little reward. So what happened when she went and made this record? Well, her single off the LP, a cover of Downtown, went on the Billboard Hot 100 up to 82. And in 3 weeks, she sold 250,000 LPs. That's pretty amazing, isn't it? So that and the other famous song, which Dr. Demento plays, Boots Were Made for Walking, and I illustrated that in here too. So while she was doing all this, she got to do two Ed Sullivan shows. That's pretty cool. She sang a duet with Jimmy Durante, which is on YouTube. She was having, she was at the Coconut Grove, which is a famous club, and she was sitting next to Natalie Schaefer. And I probably mispronounced that, I'm sorry. Natalie was the Miss Lovey Howe on Gilligan's Island, and she was talking to her and kept calling her by her last name. And Natalie said, well, dear, you can call me by my first name. And Mrs. Miller said, well, you can call me Mrs. Miller. So it's in all the biographical information I've read, she's old-fashioned and remains so. In fact, she walked out of a recording session after a musician, darn musicians, said something blue or profane, and she walked out. And what she did is they put her in a glass booth so she couldn't hear the musicians' talks while she did her, quote-unquote, singing. So it's like, well, the first song you'll hear, I've chosen a song off the Greatest Hits LP, and both songs that I like are not the popular songs. One of them has been played on Dr. Demento one time, I think a long time ago, and this other one I can't find any reference of. So I tried to choose something that wasn't, already hadn't been around the block downtown many, many times. And the song I'm going to play for you for sure, depending on the time restraints here, is, and I don't remember the name, so I'm going to put it on the screen, but it's a lounge song, sort of a cheesy sounding lounge. It's a theme from the Sandpiper movie, I believe, if I'm remembering correctly. I didn't bring the LP down with me. And it's I like it. It's great. It's like one of the more subtle songs on the LP, but it's you won't mistake it. The rest of the LP is like that. Then, Capitol said, hey, we got something here. So they made two more records. And then she went to this small label and did an album called Mrs. Miller Does Her Thing. And apparently she's on the cover holding a plate of brownies that are green. It's like, oh, here I am serving up, a plate of pot brownies, which she would have probably disagreed with. So the songs, many of these songs are on an Ultra Lounge. It's called Ultra Lounge. It's Wild and Cool Swing, and it's a Miss Miller compilation of songs, including this one or two that I'm going to be playing for you. Well, I said before that she, once all this fame was over, she went to Vietnam and entertained the troops. You can imagine what a hoot that was. But after all the success eventually petered out, she still made a couple of records on her own dime, and probably 45s. I'm not sure. It's very difficult to find information on those rarities. One, I think's a record for distribution to orphanages, so it was a song for children, and she did fundraisers, I guess the remainder of her time performing, after her quote-unquote retirement, to raise money for places like orphanage, or like an orphanage. It was interesting, and again, I stress that once it was all over, she said it was happy it was over, I guess. You figure the person, lady her age, just staying home, doing whatever she did and singing in church, and suddenly, ending up doing this sort of thing for 18 months, it must have been really hard. I can't imagine. The thing of it is that when I create something like this, I'm sort of extending her memory, some in my own fashion, and, all these things are sort of positive things. I know sometimes I make fun, and I ain't made any fun of this. I think it's just priceless. And I think they're all priceless. But the thing of it is that she knew when it came down to it what she was doing. So it wasn't like, here's an LP, this is serious. And they made it not to be serious. So in a way, it's like fudging that line where, like, some things are made to be kind of like a spoof or a comedy, and that sort of takes away some of the fun. I mean, I can enjoy certain things like that, but there are artists out there that make a living creating parodies of things. And I just have no interest in listening to it because I know it's a parody. This is kind of like half and half. Here's a person that was serious. People found her. They knew they may have something. Actually, it was a surprise, the sales, but that was an oddball thing, and they went with it. And she kind of understood it when she was like in the middle of it and doing it, but she was serious going into it, and that was the thing that made it fun. So there you go. That's it. And thanks for watching. And I hope you're no more afraid now than when you click the clicky thing.
Kissed your lips, and so.